Electricity demand. Demand for electricity is skyrocketing due to the development of artificial intelligence, battery factories, large data centers, and electric vehicles. And there are countries that may not be prepared for this reality. One of them is the United States. All this energy demand is not only putting electrical networks to the limit, but is also destroying climate objectives. According to analysis by the New York Times, which has sounded the alarm at what they believe is a turning point, energy is generated in a few specific places. Yet, our air-conditioning homes, business, and factories are everywhere. The problem is not so much that we consume a lot, but that we all do it at the same time. It is the warmest hour that, let's say, everyone turns on the air conditioning and more demand is generated. The electrical grid of any country is not designed to be able to support enormous synchronized demands, all at the same time, in a specific manner, but rather based on the diversity of demand. They are the high voltage lines and the others that are responsible for carrying energy from the production plants to all corners of the country. These lines, however, are still cables and have limited capacity. The problem is that its capacity decreases when it's hot. This is compounded by the fact that the more energy it carries, the hotter it gets. The metal conductor of the line expands and causes it to fall. In extreme cases, if the line draws too much, it can come into contact with the ground, causing a short circuit and ending the line's ability to carry power. In this episode, we cannot resort to renewable energies, such as wind or hydroelectric power either. This is where other production centers, such as nuclear, thermal, and gas, take over. With that line out of service, other lines have to pick up the load, but they also become overloaded and are prone to the same problem. Additionally, as the amount of energy carried by this line increases, the amount of energy lost through them due to heat also increases. In this scenario, the forecasts are not very favorable in the United States. It is expected the maximum demand in summer will grow by 38,000 megawatts through the country in the next 5 years, according to analysis by the consulting firm Grid Strategies, which is like adding another California to the network. Learn about our fleet management consulting and training services. Reduce costs and optimize fleet management activities. We electrify your fleet of vehicles. We carry out the electrification plan until its implementation, known as. It's too hot, and there are more and more centers that demand energy 24 hours a day. The United States is facing a serious problem in its electrical grid. Data center, crypto mining, and the expansion of artificial intelligence at the heart of giants such as Amazon, Apple, Google, or Microsoft are catapulting the weak electrical grid in a state like Georgia, where demand is now 70 times greater than a decade ago. Not to mention the problems facing Texas, the frying pan of North America. Tesla asked its customers not to recharge the car batteries in last summer heat waves. As was the case in Texas, the Electric Reliability Council of Texas asked residents to limit electricity use between 2 p.m. and 8 p.m. during the recent heat wave. The system is being taken to a stream that could lead to electricity rationing. In California, electric vehicle could soon account for 10% of peak energy demand. The global electric vehicle charging infrastructure market is expected to reach 125.39 billion by 2030, from 25,000 currently. Electricity demand. A study by the National Renewable Energy Laboratory, it estimated that to meet the charging priority for 2030, a cumulative investment of between 31 billion and 55 billion will be needed for about 1.1 million publicly accessible charging units, in addition to about 28 million domestic charging units. The electric vehicle paradox. And this is where we return to the paradox of the electric vehicle, which includes semiconductor and battery factories, since its demand is also contributing an unprecedented increase in electricity. To meet it and avoid a blackout scenario, utility states including Georgia, North Carolina, South Carolina, Tennessee, and Virginia are proposing to build dozens of power plants over the next 15 years that could burn natural gas, something that will not help the United States' decarbonization goals of generating all electricity for pollution-free sources, such as wind, solar, and nuclear, by 2035. Renewable energies. Once again, the problem lies in the bureaucratic nightmare that surrounds renewables. A data center can be built in just 1 year. It can take 5 years or more to connect renewable energy projects to the grid, and a decade to build some of the long-distance power lines they require. According to the data collected by the Washington Post, the 2,700 data centers in the United States, they consume more than 4% of the country's total electricity in 2022, according to the International Energy Agency, and by 2026, it will be 6%. So the solution is to ease the procedures to install more renewable energy, more high-voltage transmission lines, rejuvenate the electrical grid, and even more importantly, limit the number of data centers and factories in a single state. At least 75 data centers have been opened in Virginia alone since 2019. Vehicle fleets, net zero emission cycle. The net emission cycle is the polluting emission from the moment the electricity is generated until the consumption in the electric vehicle. Currently, the different international standards do not include polluting emission from vehicle manufacturing and battery manufacturing and recycling. Due to the development of artificial intelligence, battery factories, large data center and electric vehicles, electricity consumption has skyrocketed. If this electricity is generated with fossil fuels, the net emission cycle of the electric vehicle is not zero. The vehicle pollutes due to energy generation. To ensure that the net emission cycle in an electric vehicle is zero, energy generated by renewable energies such as wind, solar, or hydraulic must be consumed. The paradox of the electric vehicle. Electric vehicles are put charged in the fleet to have a zero emission cycle, but they are polluted by the generation of electricity if it is generated with fossil fuels, in addition to the manufacture of the vehicle and the manufacturing and recycle of the batteries. Currently, electric vehicle manufacturers are making investments so that the energy consumed in the manufacture of the vehicle at the manufacturing and recycle of the battery is from renewable energy. Climate change. Due to climate change, more and more heat waves are occurring, which can overload the electrical grid and cause electricity rationing at certain times of the day. In any case, it's not that the charging electric car is going to cause the electrical grid to fail, and this become more and more numerous and heat waves become more and common, we could see mishaps similar as Tesla in Texas. The objective will be to avoid too much simultaneous demand and prevent rationing or collapse. If we have electric vehicles in the fleet, we must have an energy recharging plan in heat waves. We must take into consideration that if the vehicles cannot be used, the service cannot be provided. At night, the aggregate demand of electrical grid is the minimum, and there are no power outages. In a fleet of vehicles, the vehicles must always be recharged at our facilities. It's not recommended to recharge a public or third-party chargers because they might not work, they might be busy, and during the tunnel recharging, the vehicle is not being used to provide the service. It's always recommended to always recharge at night at the most economical rate, and with the slowest charge possible so as not to degrade the battery. One solution is to have solar panels and seasonal batteries in our facilities to store energy from solar energy and the electrical grid in case of a power outage. It's an expensive solution, may be feasible if there are many power outages with waves or heat, or in those countries with many supply cuts such as underdeveloped countries. Another solution is to have electricity generators to recharge vehicles. This solution is an emergency and pollutes.